ask you. I never could leave, you gotta believe. But you think my heart's not there? Cause it's been a while, you keep telling me it's been a while. Let me tell you something, yes, I know we've been together for so long.
Everybody, it's Trace Look here from Black Hair Compass. I am coming to you guys with my 9-month lock update. I want to give you a bit of a disclaimer. If it seems like I'm a little bit less energetic than I usually am, it is because I am. A lot of the things happening with police brutality and police murder and footage surfacing all over social media has really been affecting me, and I wasn't even really sure that I wanted to film anything, because I knew that it was kind of showing. But I'm gonna stick to my schedule. I do my monthly lock updates, and I'm gonna stick to that. So I just wanted to explain that in case you kind of sense and feel that something's a little bit different. It is because there is something different. But I digress. So I am here with my 9-month lock update. This is a pretty big milestone. I mean, because I was thinking about it the other day, this is the amount of time I would need to have a baby. 9 months, that's a really long time. So I want to start out with, I don't know why exactly, but this month has been a month where I've been kind of like annoyed with my hair, a little bit frustrated, and it reminds me of the way that I felt around month 3 and month 4. And in hindsight, in looking back, I was able to see that it was in month 3 and month 4 that a lot of change was happening, and that's probably why I was kind of like irritated and annoyed with my hair. So I'm thinking that maybe once I reach my 1-year mark and I look back at month 9, I'll be able to see this is a period of a lot of change. That's what I'm thinking is going on. That's probably why I'm irritated and annoyed, but yeah, I don't know. It's just kind of, I have like these locks in the front of my face that always fall in my face. It's one of the most irritating things ever. It's always in my line of sight, and it's just annoying. I don't like it. And I also feel like it's probably a small thing, but my locks, the shape of my locks is not really even on both sides, and part of that is because, you know, they're developing at different speeds and in different stages. But also, probably the biggest thing is that if you guys have been following me for a while, you remember I got box braids right before I was due to deliver my daughter. And when I took those box braids out, I accidentally cut some of my hair. So this like indentation here is my own doing. When I was cutting the braids out, I accidentally cut some of my own hair, not realizing that that's what I was doing. But what it has, but while it was a loose natural, it wasn't really that obvious. But now that I have locks and I'm looking at my hair every day, I can see that incongruency, and it irritates me a little bit, probably because I have a little bit of OCD kind of kicking in, but it bothers me. And I try not to let it get to me, but it does. So one of the ways that I've been combating that is to kind of just wrap up my hair, you know, wear some head wraps every now and then, just to kind of switch it up and take my mind off of it, and that seems to be working. Also, I did want to update you guys. In my 8-month lock update, I showed you that I had a section of locks somewhere in the back where I just couldn't find the parts. And at the beginning of my journey, had I come across an issue like that, I would have taken some scissors and cut, but I learned that that's actually really bad to do. So I decided to try something else and just leave my locks alone, keep the length of the locks separated, but not really do too much to detangle the roots, and just kind of like let it work itself out. And it just so happened that that's exactly what happened. I can't really explain to you why they kind of came loose, but they just did. Those 3 locks that were joined at the roots found a way to not be joined anymore. And once that kind of like loosened up, I did go in and interlock, because I had, there was just a lot of loose fuzzy hair that was now out of the locks. So I went ahead and I interlocked them to kind of like reintegrate that hair back into those locks. But I just wanted to update you guys and let you know that hypothesis I had about just kind of like leaving things be and let them work themselves out, and it worked in this case. So perhaps if you find yourself in a situation where you have locks that are kind of like locked together at the root because you kind of accidentally grabbed a couple hairs, make sure you keep the locks separated, and you might want to just try and kind of like give it some time to work itself out, because it did work for me. Also, this has been so I told you guys I'm reintegrating soap, regular usage of soap, back into my regimen. But I was considering just sticking to, you know, I retwist my hair every 6 weeks, so I was going to wash my hair every 6 weeks. But something happened that made me reconsider that. Something that I do in between my washes is I spritz my hair with plain water every day. And I was starting to notice that whenever I spritzed my hair with water, my hair had this smell. But it smelled good to me. Like, it smelled almost like cake batter. Like, it had a sweet smell. So what I was thinking was that maybe there's some remnants of the soap, or maybe remnants of the rinse in my hair, and when I'm wetting it, it's activating it. So that's what I thought. But then I spritzed my hair and I asked my husband, I was like, can you smell my hair? Like, what does it smell like? He's like, it smells like when you first open a package of hot dogs. And I was like, hot dogs? So I don't know how we had two entirely opposite smell experiences with that, but nonetheless, regardless of what the smell was, I was noticing that whenever my hair got wet, it became odorous, like some sort of like smell was emanating. To me it smelled sweet, to him it smelled like hot dogs. Nonetheless, I don't think that that's normal. My hair should not be having an odor when wet, because, and the reason for that is because generally speaking, you will come across hair having a different smell when wet if there is bacteria and or fungus present. I don't think that I have fungus in my hair, because as you guys know, I have like cut several of my locks and cut them in half just to see what's there, and I haven't seen any fungus or anything, but I do think that there is a possibility that bacteria started to grow in my hair. Now, that's not necessarily something that would alarm me, because one, not all bacteria is bad bacteria, but two, I mean, it's kind of inevitable. If you go outside, you're gonna come in contact with bacteria. It'll be on your hands, it'll be on your skin, your clothes, your hair. So I'm like, it's not something that made me freak out, because it is quite common and natural and normal. But what concerned me is the fact that once wet, it had a different smell. So just to take precaution and make sure that, you know, that I'm not doing anything to promote bad bacteria from proliferating in my hair, what I decided to do was switch the water that I'm using from tap water to distilled water. And I have also decided to increase the number of washes that I'm doing. I know it's kind of a big jump, but I'm thinking I'm gonna jump from washing my hair every 6 weeks to washing my hair once a week. Yeah, and instead of using, you know, all of the different fragrances that they have, that Dr. Bronner's has, I decided that I'm going to wash my hair with their tea tree soap. And the reason I'm using the tea tree soap is because tea tree oil naturally is antibacterial and antifungal. Tea tree oil can kill all the known types of fungus that we have on Earth. I don't know if we can't necessarily say the same thing about it being able to kill all forms of bacteria, but it can kill all forms of fungus, and it can kill a significant amount of bacteria. So I was like, if in fact the reason that my hair has this different odor when wet is because of bacteria and or fungus, I'm going to use the tea tree soap just to have that as a regular part of my regimen to keep that in check. So that's that. And I also decided to switch from tap water to distilled water, because in the event that there are organisms in the tap water and I'm spraying that on my hair continually, that could be a source of, you know, actually putting organisms in my hair. So I was like, let me just switch to distilled water. And it wasn't expensive. It was like $2 for a gallon of distilled water, and I'm going with that. I also decided to use essential oils in the distilled water. I'm not putting anything like olive oil or coconut oil in it or anything like that. I put peppermint oil in there for fragrance, and I also put like a couple of drops of tea tree oil in there, again, for its antibacterial and antifungal properties. So that just in case, the reason that my hair was smelling different when wet was because of those things, I'm just taking preventative measures now. As far as I can think, that's pretty much all that's been going on in the 9 months. Just a little bit of frustration, irritation with my hair. Probably because in hindsight, I'll be able to see this is kind of a transitionary month where my hair is changing. So I'm just gonna be patient through it and, you know, get to the 1 year mark. Again, the marrying of my locks totally resolved itself. Didn't have any issues there. And then again, just the changes in my wash routine, because I don't want to do anything that could support the growth of bad bacteria or fungus in my hair. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for tuning in, and as always, I will see you guys next week.